everybody, thanks for joining us for Grown Man Record Night and this installment of Chip Chat. I mean, for a Friday, it's been a rather somber evening. I'll have to say we lost my cousin this morning. That's a shame. He was a hell of a gentleman, and spent a lot of time with him. Took me on the ballooning trips when I was a kid. Helped incorporate me into the being on a balloon chase crew, which nobody in elementary school, by the way, believed I was on a balloon chase crew. The cameraman didn't believe I was on a balloon chase crew, and my cousin Keith took me on a balloon chase crew, and I was the 12-year-old kid that ran up to the houses and said, "Excuse me, sir, can we land in your field?" And they would say, "All right." And so we would then land the balloon in the field, and I went to a balloon port that's somewhere around here, and I'm still not exactly sure where that balloon port's at, but I know it exists because we went there, and it was a good time. I had a good time with Keith. He lived down the hill from me. We spent some time together. He bought me some things when I was a kid. And as a kid, you appreciate that when somebody buys you something. And he took me ballooning. That was neat because there was radios and balloons and flames. And as a kid, that's neat. That's neat. And it was something nobody else was doing in my elementary school. And it was a good time. So we're going to miss Keith. He's a good gentleman. So peace out to Keith. And we're moving on to Chip Chat. We're moving on to Chip Chat because you got to keep on keeping on, man. One thing I learned from Lamont Sanford, you got to keep on keeping on. And you can harp on a bunch of BS if you want, but you got to keep on keeping on. So you might as well have a good time while you're doing it. And it's damn Friday, and we're going to damn hang out, and we damn been doing it all damn night long. Bunch of gigs in a week and a bunch of cool records, and now we got some chips to talk about. Woo! All right. Let's get it in with some Chip Chat. Started with a little open bag special. We got a little Lay's Deli style original. Not really had these before. They're good, now. Got a good soft texture. Elizabeth. Kind of a scam, though, I'll tell you. They're good. I don't know what Lay's is charging extra for these for. I don't know how different these are than the actual Lay's original. Which is a little thicker? Maybe a little thicker. It's a good chip either way, but they taste like the Lay's original, which that's a good chip, too. I'm not talking mess about them, because it's straight up old Lay's original potato chips. It's a good damn potato chip, as Lucy says, I'm a damn self. Breathe. So I've got a special open bag special this evening. This is my convenience store portion of the program. I rediscovered the Munchos a couple of years ago, and the only reason I discovered them was because the Munchos are always $2, and it seems like quite a bit of product for $2, and that's cool. And so I started buying them. And the Munchos, if you've not had them before or recently, Munchos are a different texture than other potato chips. They're like really light, really crispy. I do have to say they're pretty salty. Yeah, you know, we feel about sodium on the program. We're going to limit it sometimes. And we're going to talk a little more about that coming up. Oh, breathe. Oh, bucket. But the Munchos have a different texture than any other potato chip. They're really light. They're really crispy. And I really didn't experience Munchos until much later in life. Probably from, is this going to end? They're doing something. It's going to end eventually, and we'll switch record. But Munchos are different. I learned about Munchos by being on the road and playing music and stopping at convenience stores. It's a $2 chip. And then sometimes I would buy these $2 chips, and it's from the same company. This is the Chester's Flamin' Hot Fries, and these things are pretty hot. And I started getting these because it's a good deal, just like the Munchos, and because you couldn't eat too many of them at a time. So I'd eat these during the week so that wouldn't kill them all at one time. Oh, no, did I spit something out? I don't know. I'll find it. Okay. So, but my tip is really this. This is what I started doing for $4. You can take these two here. And you know how you buy a pack of chips? There's always this room at the top of the chips, right? They never fill them to the top. It's not like you're buying, you know what I'm saying? I remember when I was a kid, I was like, oh, that's baloney. You buy a pack of chips and it's only half full. And, well, they settle, Michael. They got to settle. Oh, physics lesson for free. So, you spend $4, $2 only, and there's lots of room, and then here's what you do. Let's get down to brass tea. Brass tea, you fill up this bag with this bag, get that bag out of the way. Here's what you're going to do. You're going to shake it on up. I shake it up. And now what you got? Oh, I didn't shake them up very good. They're not shook up very good. But what'll end up happening over time is that you get like a muncho and a hot fry, gentlemen. Oh, boy. So they start saturating one another. And I'm eating that one. Okay, I'm eating that one. Oh, hang on. Here's another song from my man Scott Cross. This is the end credit song for Fletch. And damn it, everybody loved Fletch. Crying out loud. And this is what they're actually playing over the credits of Fletch when he says, I charge it all to the Underhills. Want the number? Bit by bit. So that's this song. It's just a 45 I picked up at a little thrift store, and I'm going to play some, get some other rock and roll business. So I'm just getting this all set up, ready for use. Okay, we're back to Chip Chat. I got one more piece of business, part of new business I want to tell you about. Woo! Several weeks ago, we told you about in Chip Chat, one of the first Chip Chats, actually, about the No Salt Utz potato chip. And that's still a favorite in this household. We like the No Salt. We like adding our own spices when we want spices on a potato chip because potatoes taste good by themselves. But here's a new twist on that. They're hard to find. Utz has produced the No Salt Added Barbecue Potato Chip. These are terrific. And it's barbecue potato chips minus all the salt. And it's very unique because when you get done with all the salt in the barbecue potato chips, what you're left with is a lot of sugar, granted. It's not like it's health food. It's just less sodium. So if you got problems with your blood pressure, these bleeds, these rosary bleeds right here, these bleeds. Now, I've been called a lot of things in my day. I ain't never been called no commie. Anyhow, these no salt added. Mr. Kitty walking through, checking out records, keeping it moving. He's got warrants and shit. He can't be on camera. I appreciate that. I know people got warrants. It's cool. Anyhow, these without the salt, but the barbecue almost tastes like sweet potato because there's no salt, but there's still that maltodextrin flavoring kind of going. We want to open them up. We'll open them up. I tell you what, this time I'll give the cameraman the first go around on it. I'm not selfish. Said the shrimp to the clam. I'm not shellfish. So if the guy says thumbs up, you see what I mean? They're kind of, it's no salt, but they're still sweet. It's almost like sweet potato. It's good. They're not the best thing for you, but if you're really watching your sodium, it's a good thing to check out. This record's ending. Hey, check it out. We're going to bring in some wings. Really? Yeah? Some wings. This is a really good record. This is the Venus and Mars record. Really good, man. And I forget I got it sometimes, and sometimes somebody's got to remind me. It's like, is that good? And I'm like, wait. Actually, it quite is. We're going to play this. We're going to play that John Prine we talked about earlier. Boy, we sure do appreciate you hanging out on Grown Man Record Night. It's been a Black Friday. Lost a couple people this week. Dave Brubeck, Cousin Keith. And that's all right, man. Music keeps going. It's not all right, but it's all right. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? You just keep it moving, man. That's all you got to do. Keep it moving. So thanks for joining us. And we'll see you next week. We got some holiday things coming up. We're going to have a good time. Have us a holiday party. Maybe another studio audience. Do you guys like that? Another studio audience? Have some friend of yours show back up. And we'll have a good time and have some hors d'oeuvres. We'll have some hors d'oeuvres and we'll talk about music and have a good old time. And we'll have a New Year's special and some 45s and some guests showing up. More of us sure are going to have a good time. And we hope you join us for more Grown Men Record Night. Thanks for joining us for this episode of Chip Chat. We got a YouTube channel, YouTube.com/MacheteMiller. You can find all our segments, Dig of the Week, and Dig of the Week and Chip Chat. So check us out on YouTube, subscribe, become our friend, because we sure do appreciate you. And happy holidays from all of us here at Grown Men Record Night. Salome!